Today I'm going to be teaching you how to make a miraculous organic fertilizer. It's almost like a wonder cure for your orchids out of what would have otherwise been household waste, your eggshell. This is going to help maintain the strength of your plant and keep them blooming. Let's show you how we're going to turn these eggshells into this wonder product for your plants. And welcome to the Nature Company. If this is the kind of information you're interested in, please hit that subscribe button down below if you haven't already, and that notification bell to be notified of all our upcoming videos so you don't miss out on a thing.
I know we've all tried this before. Eggshells are extremely hard. We've put them in the garden and they just have stayed there like that, cutting our fingers as we try and dig to put something back in. The calcium carbonate in here is going to take months or years to decompose. So even if we grind this into a powder and sprinkle it onto our orchids, all it's going to do is clog up those air gaps, and it's not going to decompose and produce a form of calcium that's going to be absorbed by the plant quickly enough to treat that calcium deficiency. So how do we go about it? Well, let's get through all the processes to start with, and then we'll get to making our wonder cure. These eggshells now have been baked just to the point where they start going brown, so that they're not burnt. The reason that we do this is to just burn off any residue, kill off any bacteria or fungal spores that may be on it. Just make sure that there's not going to be any contaminants into the mix. We also wash them out nicely so that this heating process will be more effective. And the method we're going to use to make this calcium carbonate into a form that the plants can readily uptake is by using a mild acid or vinegar. Vinegar is a really good mild acid. It's acetic acid, and it reacts with the calcium carbonate of the eggshells, form calcium acetate, carbon dioxide, and water. So it's really a non-hazardous method of extracting what we want out of it. And the calcium acetate is very easily absorbed directly by the plants. This calcium acetate is then absorbed by the plant and used in its cell membranes and its cell walls. So it's non-motile. Once it moves to the area that it's needed and is taken up, it stays there. It doesn't get moved around the plant afterwards. So the plant is going to need a constant supply of this calcium, especially for that new growth and for those buds to really form well and produce wonderful flowers. And with it being in the calcium acetate form, we can use it as a foliar feed and for feeding in through the roots, because as the foliar feed, it's going to be absorbed in straight into the leaves and be used there at source. And by pouring it in through the roots, it's going to be sucked up through the xylem and sent to those growing points and allow for those new growths to be formed well. Now to get to the processing of these eggshells, now that they've all been cleaned and cooled, we can either just crush them up into a fine mix like that and throw that into our vinegar, but then this is going to take longer to be processed. So we want to try to do this in the shortest time as possible. We don't want to wait 7 to 14 days for this to have finished its chemical reaction with the vinegar so that we can use our product. The fastest way to get it done is either by using a pestle and mortar and crushing them finely, or instead of going old school, we're going to take our blender and throw our eggshells in there. Finer powder that we produce by blending, the faster the reaction is going to take place and the quicker you're going to have your calcium acetate to feed your plants. It's just providing more of a surface area for those chemical reactions to take place. And now getting to our mix. Here we have a 5% vinegar, and I'll explain to you later why the percentage or the percentage strength of your vinegar is important. But with our vinegar, what we're going to do is we're going to put 10 times the weight of vinegar to the weight of the eggshells. So basically here, this will be 2/3 of the bottle, and then our eggshells. You'll notice a fuzzing reaction happening. You'll get all this, these air bubbles and that. That's just the vinegar reacting with the calcium, producing carbon dioxide. So you don't have to worry about that. And the reason that you're going with so much vinegar to your eggshells is to ensure that you have enough reactive material to draw out all of that calcium that's in the calcium in the shells. To provide a complete reaction. And now there we have our fun. A volcano. So to avoid that, you can just put your calcium in your eggshells in a bit slower. And for this very reason, is the same reason you don't want to get vinegar on your granite countertops. So quick clean up there. Now what we're going to do is, this is still going to be producing carbon dioxide for a while, so we can't just put a lid on, otherwise we'll have another explosive event happening in our kitchen. So we're going to take a breathable fabric, put that over the top so that carbon dioxide can still keep escaping. And then just close that over. You can see all those bubbles still forming, the reaction taking place vigorously there. And with this being so finely crushed, within a couple of hours, this should be ready to use. But you just make sure that all this bubble formation has stopped. As soon as you can see that has stopped, then you know that the reaction is fully complete. If you've only just broken it, your eggshells into larger pieces, this reaction is going to take a while. It will take from 7 to 14 days for this reaction to stop taking place. Only then will you be able to use your calcium water. And the calcium water that you obtain from this is actually relatively stable. You'll take it, filter it out, so that you don't have any of the eggshell residue left, and that calcium water you'll be able to store just in a cool place out of direct sun, and it should last several months. So let me explain a little bit about this reaction that's taking place and why the percentage strength of your vinegar makes a difference. What's happening is one calcium molecule is reacting with two acetate molecules. So if you've used a 5% vinegar mix, you're going to land up with a 2.5% calcium acetate mix in your water. The same going to happen if you've got a 3% vinegar, you're going to land up with a 1.5% calcium acetate in your water mix. So this is just going to help you with your feeding regime, because it's generally suggested with a 3% CalMag solution that you're going to be using 2 milliliters in 1 liter of water, or 5 mils, which is a teaspoon, in 1 gallon. So it's just going to help you with your mixing ratio, so you're making sure that you feed your plant correctly with the right quantity of calcium. Feeding your orchid with this calcium acetate water from the eggshells is also going to give it trace elements of phosphorus. This is going to help the plant develop its systems for the absorption of calcium, which all in all is going to make your plant stronger and healthier.
And thank you for watching. If you find any of this information helpful, please hit that like button. hit that subscribe button down below and that notification bell, bing bong, to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on things.